Welcome back to the 5th Annual State Champs Signing Day Special. The Midwest Football Recruiting Manager for Scout.com is with me. Alan True, always a valuable resource when it comes to recruiting throughout the state of Michigan and beyond. We appreciate you always making time for us.
Of course.
All right, good. We want to turn our attention now to the Mid-American Conference, better known as the MAC. We have three programs in the MAC that reside in the state of Michigan, and all three coming off pretty solid seasons. Let's start with Eastern Michigan. 7-6 record, their first bowl appearance in 29 years. They went 1-11 in 2015. So is that success now translating into a higher caliber of recruit?
It is a little bit. I think some kids have bought in, and they got a really big fish from the state of Michigan in Jairus Grissom, a quarterback from River Rouge. Kid had over 20 offers, could have gone a whole lot of other places, had some schools come in late to try to poach him. He sticks with EMU, and I think that season had a lot to do with it. Going to have a really good receiver from in-state, Blake Bogan, to throw to.
How would you grade out Eastern Michigan for a recruiting class this year?
I give this class a B+. They've done well in the JUCO ranks. They've done well out of state. And then anytime, I think quarterback's such an important position, especially in their offense. You get Grissom, that bumps the class up.
All right, we're talking MAC recruits. Let's turn our attention now to Central Michigan. John Bonamigo took over a couple of years ago. 2016 was a kind of a roller coaster ride for the Chippewas. CMU went 6-7 on the year. Not a great showing versus Tulsa at the Miami Beach Bowl, but this will be his third class, usually a big class. How's he doing? What's the class that's coming?
Well, again, they've built this program with a lot of in-state kids. Cooper Rush and guys like that have done really well up there. And it's good on the offensive line this year. Both lines actually coming in from in-state. Eric Ditz-Hazy is a kid from Forest Hills Northern that we think is going to be a really good player for them at offensive tackle. Jonathan Berghorst, a really strong kid from Zeeland East, my alma mater, as a matter of fact, one of the strongest players in the state. So those two guys coming in on both lines, I think that's a really good class for Bonamigo and the Chips.
So grade out this year's CMU recruiting class.
I'm going to give them a B. You know, they lost a few MAC battles. Western Michigan took some guys that they were interested in, but I think they finished the class strong, picked up some athletes, a couple kids from Ohio. I think that really helped the class towards the end.
All right, so finally, Western Michigan. Like the nation, we all saw what P.J. Fleck and his Broncos were able to do. Run the table all the way to the Cotton Bowl before losing to Wisconsin. Everybody was rowing the boat this year, right? So flash forward to today. Fleck is gone in Minnesota. Some recruits have followed. Former Broncos quarterback Tim Lester is now the head coach. Who are some of the guys that stuck to their commitments? And just give an overview of where Western Michigan is at right now. And can they convince other guys to switch their commitments before signing day?
Well, I think they're going to still finish with a strong class. Obviously, you take over late like Lester did with half a class gone. Right. There's some difficulties there, but he assembled the staff quickly. They hit the road. They kept some key guys. A couple of linebackers from in-state that I think are really good. Dwayne Chapman was an outstanding player at Orchard Lake St. Mary's. You get a kid from a great program there. There's still definitely some pieces there to work with coming in.
So despite Fleck leaving, grade out Western Michigan's class right now.
Well, I have to give it a C just because they lost so many guys, had to scramble to fill some of those spots late. So I think next year will be your true grading of Tim Lester and his class. With his first class, he just had to do what you could do in these last few weeks to fill out the recruiting class.
We taped this show on Thursday. This is airing Saturday. Obviously, a lot can happen between now and Wednesday. Do you see Western getting in on some guys maybe that we didn't think about?
Yeah, I think so. Now, they've done that a little bit in other states. They've gone into Wisconsin and gotten some guys who are committed other places, gone into Indiana and done that. So they may still look at some. I know some of the GLIAC schools may be a little nervous about Western talking to some of their commits, so that could happen still.
That is this year's MAC Attack. Lots more from Allen to come.